So next day when Baba came in the Mandli's hall at Mehrazad, he said, I am very much upset because of this sudden illness of Kekobad, and because of that, the timetable, my whole timetable has been upset, and the thing that I wanted to give and my manifestation, everything has been postponed, and I'm very much upset. And after a while, Baba actually began to cry like a child, and it was a most unusual sight. For some time he was crying like a child, and then again he said, you see, because of this accident of Kekobad, it has upset my whole plan, and now I will have to do it myself alone. He was participating in my work and it was very important, but this accident of Kekobad has upset everything, and now I will have to do it myself alone, and everything, the plan will have to be changed considerably.
Mansari, you once told me that there was a snake that came into your room a long time ago, and that there was a whole story connected around that.
Yes, Edward, I will willingly tell you. On the month of August 1951, in the evening, at 8 o'clock, we were just chatting. I was chatting with Kekobad's family. I have no idea what will happen. But then, after that, I went to retire at night. Now the room in which I was staying, that was Baba's cage room. Many of you might have remembered. And I wanted to get in as usual, but something hold on. That is, I just hesitate to go get in. It was just in my mind that someone might be there. I just couldn't help. And with the help of light, I entered the room. And I saw up and down, of course the room is not so big, up and down and everywhere. But I couldn't find anything. Then, at last, I was so sleepy, I went in bed at 8:45 and I slept like a log. Yes, when he left for new life, Baba gave me four or five sticks, long sticks, saying that if anyone comes, you break their heads with it. I have kept all the time by the side of my bed. But then what happened? At about 11:45, I felt something cold and rubbery on my chest. I just didn't care because I feel so sleepy at that hour. I turned my side, but at that time it just came to my mind that it might be a lizard, so I got up. And I shake off that sheet which was on my body. And I wanted to turn the light on. As soon as I got down, I heard the sound, tap. And what I saw, it was a snake, it was a cobra. Again coming, what was on my chest, and what I felt, cool and rubbery feelings. Then it began to come up to me again, and began to crawl on the bed. Then I lighted another lantern, and forgetting I have four sticks with me, which Baba has given, I went in another room, in the kitchen, and with the woods which has been used as fuel, I brought that, and with the help of it, I just killed it. And then it took me so much time. Then at about 2 o'clock, I just cleaned everything and I wanted to go to bed. As soon as I stepped, I sat on the bed. All of a sudden I saw Baba is sitting on my bed at feet side. I just couldn't help. I just shouted, "Help!" Of course, slowly, "Baba, Baba, tell me something." But just nothing, as if he doesn't want to talk to me. He just stared at the place where the snake was on my chest. I was so sleepy, but on the one hand, I wanted to see Baba more. On the other hand, I was so sleepy. So, part of the time I slept, and again I just, it came to my mind that, oh, Baba is with me. And again I saw that Baba was there, the same session, staring at on my chest where the snake was. Again I shout, "Baba, I dare not touch because perhaps he might leave me." That was the fear in me. So I just kept on staring at him, sometimes sleeping, sometimes sitting. At about five, that vision, that was vision, and the snake, the vision disappeared. Slowly faded, began to fade at 5 o'clock, and at 5:30 it was completely gone. And when Baba came after New Life, he asked me all the accounts during about 2 years. And when I told about that snake, he said that, "Now are you convinced that I am with you wherever you are, all the time?" And I said, "Of course, Baba. And if the snake comes every day, I would like if you come to on my bed every day." That is all. And he smiled and he really enjoyed.
Yes, now we are entering the Samadhi of Avatar Meher Baba, the tomb of Avatar Meher Baba. And it is here in this tomb that Baba's body is kept, the mortal body of the immortal one. Here lies the body of Avatar Meher Baba, 7 feet deep. Previously, when the crypt was prepared, you see, 30 years back when the Samadhi was built, this tomb was built, it was 6 feet deep. But when Baba's body was brought to from Mehradar and kept here in his room, then the lower part was dug, and now it is 7 feet deep and it is lying on earth. So on bare earth, Baba's body was kept 7 feet down, and then with all his clothes and rose flowers.